how do you get these organisations to better understand the unique plight of our mob when it comes to tackling violence?
I'm continually trying to get people to understand that anything that's written, the legislation, the safety plans, all the things that are run out by through domestic violence, through academics, through researchers, are seen through a white lens. And that lens does not see Aboriginal women. And I'm talking about the Aboriginal women that come into Mudjongol. Not all Aboriginal women, but a lot of Aboriginal women are living below the poverty line. And so nobody's seeing them in this domestic violence talk. Yet everyone's saying they're advocating for Aboriginal women. You can go to any organisation and yes, we advocate for Aboriginal women. There's a whole demographic that they're missing because they can't see us. And that's a problem.
You've been invited to present on this issue on the world stage at the United Nations Commission on the Status of Women in New York. What did you tell the UN?
So it's being seen at an international level and just letting all these people know that we exist. It's lovely to think that the government's going to save us from violence. The government's not going to save us. It's going to help us fund programs, you know, organisations. But, you know, it's important for us to be there and to take up space, because everyone that goes to these places that speak in Australia will talk about Aboriginal women. It's all good to be telling other people's stories, but unless you've felt what it's like to grow up as an Aboriginal person in this country, as an Aboriginal woman that's been through domestic violence, as an Aboriginal woman that's not seen, you're just guessing.
Well, you currently serve on the City of Sydney Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Advisory Panel and the DV New South Wales Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Advisory Committee as well. What outcomes are you currently working towards?
Having our voices heard. That's really taken up so much space in my work now, is just having Aboriginal women's voices heard, like listening to us in these spaces. Because, you know, domestic violence affects us more than any other nationality in this country. You know, we own the highest percentage of everything violent. That's domestic violence, family violence, child removal, incarceration, homelessness, bad health, all of it. We sit in the top percentage of all of that. And why is that? Is it because we're not being heard? Is it because we're too scared to go to the hospital? Is it because we're too scared to call the police? It's all those things. It's a real fear-based. And the fear is relevant because this country was based on making Aboriginal people fearful.